Hi guys, I'm here in New York City talking to people about native ads at Advertising Week. Let's see what they have to say.
Charlo Barbosa, nativeads.com, COO.
Wonderful.
And yourself?
John Malach, nativeads.com, CEO.
Okay, great. So first of all, and whereabouts are you guys from?
Vancouver.
Vancouver. Okay, guys, my first Canadian comrades. I am from Vancouver, BC as well.
No.
We're going to find out more about this after. So I've been asking people the same question all day long. What are native ads?
That is a great question. And to answer this question, I got to take three different perspectives. First of all, there's the native ad technology, which is any type of advertisement that fits the form and function of the website, so it looks like it belongs. Then there's the native ad copy or the native ad content. And this is content that looks more like publisher content. So there's a solid vibe and a flow from the actual content on the site through to the native ad. And then the last part is there's the native ad experience, which is when the user feels like they're not being misled, they don't feel like they're being sold to, they're being educated or entertained, one of the two.
Now, is this, would you say, the future of advertising now?
I think it's the present and the future. I think that in general, we're going to see a fusion between the advertisers and the publishers, giving kind of a more unified experience to the user, so that way they're more engaged in general, not just on the ads, not just on the content, but on everything.
Also, as well as like the brands get more educated in how native ads work, they'll start spending more money in that industry.
Now, I've heard, and you know, this is all, like floating around all around, is there backlash to this type of, industry and technology and native ads in general?
Well, you saw that piece by John Oliver. I mean, he killed the whole idea in like 2 minutes, but this is kind of the early adoption of native ads. So when you see the first type of advertisements misleading users, taking them into third-party pages with autoplay sound about get rich quick, that's the kind of stuff that's going to really bother people and create that backlash. But as people evolve the process and learn how to do it properly, I think that backlash will disappear and it's going to become the standard.
That's great. Thank you so much, guys. And I guess I'll see you back in Vancouver.
All right.
Thank you.
I am Sireesha Baljepalli, and I work for Google.
Okay, super. So what's your function at Google? What are you up to there?
I work in the agency relations team. So my job is to work with the holding companies across the industry to build relationships and partnerships.
Very cool. Now, tell me, I'm asking this question because I want to learn more, and I'm sure people out there want to learn more as well. What is native advertising? What do you think it is?
It's, you know, the way I think about it is mostly contextual advertising version 2.0. Because essentially what it is bringing advertising content that is organic to the content that the person is reading on the page. And to me, that is just contextual advertising on steroids in some ways, right? Just enabled by more nimble technology. And so that's what I think of as native advertising.
Is this the future of advertising in general now that there's so many users online?
I think so. I think it's a natural extension, right? So as brands want to become publishers and it's all about content and storytelling, this is just another extension of it, just more one-dimensional and display-related versus video, sight, sound, and motion.
I work for Bloomberg Media Group, and I run our digital media planning team in the U.S.
Awesome. Okay, so you're definitely a cool person to talk to.
I know some stuff about native, yeah.
What is native advertising?
Well, I believe that native advertising is content that feels true to the design and flow of a publisher's site. So it's advertiser messaging that's mixed seamlessly with editorial content.
And is this the future of advertising, would you say, as well?
I definitely think it's one of the waves of the future. I think that advertising now is either moving towards more of a programmatic strategy or more towards big ideas. So I think this is one of the pieces of creative advertising that's part of big ideas versus where a lot of advertising dollars are going now into programmatic.
What's Bloomberg doing with this type of technology?
Oh my gosh, you'll have to check out our sites to find out. But there's definitely stuff running right now that is our version of native. Yeah, we have some campaigns now. So
any brand that they can take advantage of content marketing, but it's the ones who really take care to ensure that their brand positioning and their brand history gives them a credible voice in conversation.
My name is Chris Paul. I work at Edelman, which is the oldest independent PR firm in the world.
But most recently, what they've done is they've kind of specialized their operation to bring in different kinds of people, maybe not from a traditional PR background. Myself come from a digital advertising, digital marketing background, so I'm trying to build the paid media capability across Edelman globally. We already have, fortunately, a couple years head start. We've been doing paid media for a lot of our clients for some time, and really it's about just formalizing the structure, developing our relationships with the big publishing partners out there and technology partners out there to bring that that sort of ad technology world closer to the content world.
The whole buzz today and talking about native advertising, did you guys use that sort of terminology like veining, or and when you hear it, does it resonate to everything that you're doing as well?
The term native advertising has been around for, you know, a few years now. It's usually what, you know, every few years we have to rebrand what we're doing to keep the excitement around reposition. I think the spirit of native advertising is alive and well at Edelman. I think the idea behind creating brand assets that are interesting and useful and less disruptive is a great ambition. It's core to what we're doing. I don't think the term is necessarily, it's not necessary to really keep the momentum going in the industry, but it's a decent way to describe this effort, as has been discussed a great deal at these panels, to make useful, interesting assets that people actually want to consume rather than assets that interrupt their consumption.
Do you believe that this is the commonplace for advertising, where it's going to go and where it's going to stay?
I think advertisers are recognizing the fact that the traditional means of getting their messages out there are becoming less effective as the days pass. And that's just a reality of the communications landscape. So one really good way to combat that and to keep yourself as a brand in the conversation and keep yourself fresh in the minds of their consumers is to be, as I said, useful and informative and entertaining to them in a way that only true content can be. I personally feel, as a consumer myself, that if a brand is useful or informative to me in a time of need, that's going to generate more loyalty for me to that brand than anything they could do in a traditional advertising way.